Welcome back. Now here's the latest from the Karnataka political turmoil. The Congress-JDS coalition government is fighting for survival as the Supreme Court has directed the Assembly Speaker to verify the resignations of the rebel MNAs by the end of the day. The top court has asked the 10 rebel MLAs to meet the Speaker at 6 p.m. today and submit their resignations, and has observed that the Speaker cannot sit on the resignations. The apex court has also refused to grant an urgent hearing to the Speaker's plea seeking more time. Let's now go across to Mukta Variyar for the latest on this. Mukta, tell us what you've picked up.
Right, you know, the trouble doesn't seem to be ending for the coalition government in Karnataka. The Supreme Court today directed the Speaker to, you know, take his decision on the resignations that the MLAs have submitted to him while he was not in office, and also when he was in office over the last few days. Remember, this comes after 10 rebel MLAs had moved the Supreme Court, citing a delay in the acceptance of the resignation by the Speaker, because the Speaker had rejected 8 of the 13 resignations on the grounds that they were not in the proper format. So the rebels had moved the Supreme Court. So the Supreme Court today has asked the Speaker to take the decision and has asked the MLAs to, you know, submit the resignations to the Speaker, meet him directly at 6 p.m. So we understand that these MLAs are now flying from Mumbai back to Bangalore. As we speak, they'll be landing in Bangalore anytime soon. And so that meeting is very crucial to watch. Like you said, the Speaker had asked for more time. He had moved the court today to seek an urgent hearing, but the Supreme Court has refused that. That may happen tomorrow. So as of now, we have to watch how that meeting between the rebel MLAs and the Speaker, you know, plays out and what decision the Speaker makes. Remember, while there are 10 MLAs had moved the Supreme Court for the delay, overall, 16 rebel MLAs have put in their resignations so far. So if these resignations are accepted, the coalition government falls, because they will not have the enough numbers, while the BJP, which has also got support from some independent MLAs who have resigned, would have the sufficient numbers to form the government.
Sir, why I have to resign? What is the necessary for me to resign now? 2009-10, the same Yediyurappa, when he was chief minister, at that time 18 MLAs, including 8 ministers in that, they opposed him. But ultimately, what has happened?
Supreme Court has ordered, naturally that will be followed, and they have to follow it. Let us see, because law is there, as per law they have to act, and Speaker will also go as per rule.
Congress will speak to the rebel MLAs
anyway? No, I don't know that, because I didn't meet anybody and I have not seen anybody. So let us wait. Our leaders have gone to Vidhan Sabha. After coming, we will decide.
All right, political turbulence in Karnataka continues, and we'll bring you the very latest right here on CNBC-TV18. Now, the Central Bureau of Investigation has conducted raids at the homes and offices of lawyer Indira Jaising, Anand Grover and their NGO Lawyers Collective. Now, earlier this year, the CBI had registered a case against Anand Grover and Lawyers Collective for alleged FCRA violations. However, the Lawyers Collective had alleged that the CBI probe was a move to silence the organization.